Okay, so we are building character assets. So first I made a duplicate of the head. Now I made a duplicate of the eye. And I'm going to call this a closed eye. So how am I going to close this eye? Well, I use my compositing skills. And I can try just Command T, transforming and warping. And maybe I have enough control here. I want to have a squint eye before I have it totally closed. See that? So I'm going to call this squinting eye. We're building the puppet. We're deciding how expressive it can be with our assets. Then I can make a duplicate of that, call that duplicate closed eye. Now, you can't do everything through warping. Eventually, you have to just cut and move. So I take that upper eyelid. I guess I didn't duplicate it. I thought I did. Duplicate. Whenever you duplicate something that you've labeled, it's very helpful. Even when you just duplicate a layer with a number in it, it will say that name with the name copy after it. And I'm going to challenge you, for the assets you're going to use a lot, actually label each layer. So you shouldn't have just lots of copies that you don't know what they are. Okay, now I've got the closed eye. I'm going to take that upper eyelid. And the internal eyelid here. And I'm going to move it. Just with the move tool. Move it down. And then I'm going to free transform it. And kind of stretch it. With the same corners. Because the corners of the eyes don't change. Just the pinching of the eyelid. Then I can do the same to the bottom. And I can just move it up. With the move tool, it will cut it out, move it up, and then warp it back to its original corners. And the reason I showed you those Terry Gilliam animations first is so that you can see this is about being kind of choppy. Okay, so what I need now is to make it a little bit darker in between that closed eye. So I can burn it. This is where all of our different compositing skills that we've learned come in. Darken it towards the middle, even darken the highlights. We have a tendency to want to be subtle when we're animating. We think it's so cinematic. But this is all going to go by so fast, we need it to be pretty obvious. So subtlety is not what we're after here. Okay, so there I've got the closed eye. And even my squinting eye could probably use a little bit of burning. And darken the lids a little. And the open eye. Okay, so what I just did, this was my first cycle. And it's just a two-frame cycle of the eye opening and closing. So Some of you have walk cycles, you know? Some of you will have wing cycles. Some of you will have tail wagging cycles. I'm gonna have a mouth drinking cycle, but this is the most basic one and it can be very effective. So how do I save my cycle? I'm just gonna organize it into a folder. So I select the layers involved in the assets and I put it into a group folder and I call that eyes closing. And I'm gonna mark it. That's my first cycle. Okay, now this is all still built on just this head. That allows me to turn off that whole cycle if I need to. Now I need a mouth. And I need the mouth to open and close. So here's the problem. I could take this. Actually, kind of take this obvious seam. I don't even need to be too careful, right? Because this will be lower resolution and going by really fast. But here's like an obvious seam to the mouth, and I can duplicate that as something separate. And then I could simply transform it and rotate it and move it down, right? Doesn't look great. If I push it back a little bit to make it a little bit more believable on that jaw, that could help. It's got all this shading and stuff above it, but I'm working on the main assets here. But I don't have anything inside the mouth, right? And there's nothing in my original design that shows that. So this is where I might need to go back. This goes to file organization again, to my assignment 2 folder, and look at my references. And sure enough, I can composite in, bring in kind of a lower open mouth. I'm going to have auto select layer turned off here so I can really control what layer I'm on. And maybe I'll turn off a lot of these texture fills for the moment. I'm making it hard to see. But what's nice is I'm not going to delete them yet because these are assets. Those texture fills can be assets in my animation. It's like a smoke machine on set, you know, that I can move and animate. All right. Now, what part of this do I need? Well, I'm just going to kind of roughly take the whole top lip. And always take more than you need. And rough cut it out. Command J, get rid of the smart layer. Then use my compositing skills. To transform it. To stretch and kind of fit it in and make it match my character somewhat. I need to tighten it up at the back here. There we go. That looks pretty good. And it's still in the frame. Okay, now what do I need to do? I need to clean it up around here. Try to show some of these teeth within reason. And then I'm going to play with the color and the levels and the saturation, make it more colorful. But I'm not going for a level of finish like I needed for assignment 2. Okay, that looks good. I can use my soft-edged eraser but I'm going to use it at 100% and start blending it in with what's behind. But not so big that I end up kind of ghosting everything. Okay, that looks good. And then I can take it at a lower opacity and take the jaw underneath and let that come through a little bit. A little bit of that color. Maybe that shape. Especially because it's going to be dipping into the water anyway. And now, levels and color balance. I'm going to make it darker. Right. Can intensify the highlights, but I don't want it too much. Can burn it. I need it to be more pronounced. Okay, but there's one other issue. And that's that in the space that's open, I still have my original. So that's why you need to build these as assets. Not always as just things that you layer on top, like I did with the eye. So I'm going to have to modify that original head to give me that space. So, what do? I move this layer. Let's see, how do I want to do it? Probably separate it here. And I duplicate that, and then I go around that with the magic wand, select inverse, and delete that same selection from my original. So that I can turn it off and on, right? And then I label it. So this is now my closed mouth. So sometimes you have to cut up your original one layer into multiple layers just to have it be useful, right? Actually, I don't love that because I want upper teeth. Let me see. I'm going to keep some of those teeth. So let me merge those back together. Now let me cut it out a little differently. So it's got some tooth to it. Yeah, this will be good. So the reason that having a plan is so important is so you can really think through everything that's going to be needed. So I'm going to take this whole bottom jaw, going to duplicate that, then select around it, and then select the inverse of that. And delete it from the layer underneath. So that there is my top jaw, right? There is it with my bottom jaw. And then here it is with my open. Oh, but I